In this lesson, I will show you how to give your team an access to your project. In the settings menu, there is a section called Team. This is the place where you can see who has access to your backend. If we get a closer look at this list of users, we see that there are three account types: website owner, administrator, and user. The website owner has access to everything on the project. The administrator can have the same access as the website owner, except that it won't be able to remove the website owner from the project. And users have a limited access to the backend. But you can fine-tune everything. Let me show you. I'm logged as the website owner, and I'm going to edit the access rights of my administrator. When I access the page of one of my teammates, I can see what are the menus he has access to. In this case, my administrator has access to all the pages of my backend. For this project, I spent a lot of time to design a very beautiful app. So maybe that time, I don't want my administrator to be able to modify the design. I uncheck the access to the design menu and I save. Let's log in as the administrator and try to modify the design of the webinar section. I have no design options in the contextual panel. You may have noticed the Good Barber logo next to some menus. You will see this logo only if you have a reseller plan or if you have purchased the white label add-on. This logo means that the page you are giving access to your user or your administrator is not white label. By default, when you add a new user to your backend, he won't have access to any Good Barber branded pages and any admin related pages. If I switch this user to administrator, you can see that by default, all those pages are deactivated. When you are a reseller, the user account type is perfect to give access to the backend to your customers. Your client will see a white label backend and the basic features of the app. In this example, my customer can manage the content of the app, send push notifications and see who are the end users of the app, and also access stats. Regarding content, you can give access to only the sections where the source is the content management system, not an external source. If you don't want your customer to access all the CMS sections of your app, you can select specific ones. Let's log as the user. I have a restricted access to the backend. I can edit the webinar section, but I can't edit the news section. Adding a new team member is easy. Just enter his email address and click Add. Then choose the account type. Modify the default settings if needed. This user won't be able to send push notifications. And save. The user has been sent an invitation to join your team. If this user has never created an account on the Good Barber platform, he will be prompted to create an account ID related to this email. If the user is already registered in the Good Barber platform, then if you want, you can accept the invitation on his behalf so that he can log directly to the backend. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time, and meanwhile, happy app building.